You ever had like a dream or a nightmare that where you're just like, it woke you up and you're just like shaking. You're like, man, I don't even want to go back to sleep after that.
Mainly it happened when I was younger. I remember having like really bad dreams, like really scary dreams. And I think that's when the mind just wanders. You see things in movies, you see things in different places, but your mind just wanders into the world. You begin to try to figure out the loopholes or the gray areas in life. And I think they all play out in your dreams, right? Like you try to make sense of things. It's not much of a nightmare, I would say. It was kind of like a weird experience, but it was very uncomfortable. There was this dream that I had, and I was walking into a track field, right? It was a huge track field. It was covered just like in like red dust, like red sand almost. It's sometimes like in the dream, you know that you have to do something. And so what I had to do was pick up a dummy, right? That was on the side of the track and carry it around the track, right?
So weird.
So I went to pick up this dummy and I put it on my back and I started walking. But all of a sudden, the dummy started pissing on me. I didn't even think of it like as funny. I was like, why is this happening? Like, I just kept on doing laps and laps around it. And it was almost like I felt stuck inside this dream and an uncomfortable reality. And so when I woke up, I was just like sweaty and stuff. And I was like, oh my God, like, what did this mean? Like, why did this even happen? Yeah. One little thing that's out of normal. And it just makes that whole dream
creepy.
Yeah.
Like the mannequin, dude, that's so creepy. Like a mannequin, but it's somehow like alive, even though it's not, even though it could not be a living being.
This one I remember a little bit more because it went into different phases. I was at a church event and then I walk into the church and there was a bunch of bats that were flying. But then I turned into a ninja and I started trying to like fight the bats. And all of a sudden, like this like flashing ninja star, I guess you could call it, passed by the side of my face. I went into a different room. There was this guy wearing a pink shirt. I remember, you know, something told me that he was gay, right? But you know, he didn't say that verbally. I kept on like walking over, and then somebody came with a mattress. And so it just things that didn't make sense. Like it's like so many weird things happening that overwhelm you. It was just like, why is this happening? Right. Like, to a certain degree, nightmares are things that can sometimes be frustrating in life, like that you don't understand. Right. It doesn't even have to be scary.
I've had some like really psychologically like disturbing dreams where I was like, what the hell is wrong? Why did I even have this dream? So one of them, like I have a lot of reoccurring dreams where I'm back in high school again, even though I've been in college for like the past 7 or so years. Like you just know certain things in dreams. Like when I was in high school in the dream, I knew that I was going to high school to get more college credits because I was still in college. Even though it makes no sense, like why would I go back to high school to get college credits when I'm already in college, you know?
Yeah.
There's a gas station next to my high school. Drove over there and there's this guy on the ground in the parking lot. And it's like his leg got run over. Because his leg is like smashed. His bones are just pieces and fragments. And there's like this guy hunched over next to him trying to help him out. And the guy was like in so much pain. Like he couldn't even scream. Like that's how his mouth was just open. Like he was just like in shock. I don't even own a truck in real life. But I got out of my truck in the dream. Went inside past that. And I was like, man, this is just so... I still went in the gas station. Oh, dude, it was just so... It's just like for some reason that just gets to me. I don't know. That was a really... Have you ever had any like disturbing dreams like that?
I think it's mainly been overwhelming. Like overwhelming things that have become nightmares. I was running for president.
Oh, yeah.
And people kept asking questions and questions and questions and questions. There was this point where I was so overwhelmed by these questions. I didn't know how to go about, you know, living. You know, it just... Oh, yeah. Yeah, I felt stuck.
Mm. Have you ever had dreams like that where you're like kind of like based on like real life stress almost?
I've had nightmares like that before actual exams and things that sort. And like you said, maybe it is stuff from our daily life that leaks in. And, you know, maybe it's a like a survival mechanism.
I had this one dream to where I was So like, it was like going in this, I guess it was like a house or something, but then the house led, it was like a mansion that led to a big room that was like a nursing home almost with a hospital bed in the middle of the room. And one of my professors in the hospital bed, it was disturbing in a sense that I felt like I couldn't do anything to fix it. His skin was like falling apart and like rotting away. Wide bandages on his arms and like kind of like something on his neck and stuff. And the closer I got, the more I noticed like how his skin like right here was missing. And it was like a green. And when I say rotting away, I mean like green, kind of like blue. The whole eyelid was like gone. And his eye was like bulging out kind of. And it was like all... like it looked like it was infected. And he like started kind of like sobbing and then crying. And he was saying like, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. And like, I could tell he was like upset, you know, and that upset me. Cause I was like, for some reason in the dream, I felt so guilty and like hopeless, I guess. I've had a lot of hospital dreams too. Like just weird surgeries. Like when I drank this cup of like a salty liquid and I fell asleep in the dream. Remember that one dream I told you?
That's insane.
Bro, where I was at St. Mary's University and I was at the clock tower. And then also, there was like all of a sudden a destroyed statue of like a saint broken into pieces in the middle of it. And then all of a sudden I went with one of my friends to like the bookstore and then came back. And then there was like these statues of like angels, like black statues. And then when I got closer with a friend, I realized there were statues of Lucifer and his followers. That one disturbed me, man. That was,
I don't think I would ever want to see like Lucifer in a dream.
Yeah, dude, that was, that freaks me out. It's happened a couple of times in my dreams and it always deeply disturbs me. It's like a broken statue of a saint. Okay, well, that means broken faith kind of. And then like the statues of Lucifer and his angels. I mean, because I've had plenty of dreams to where I felt like pain, like physical pain. Have you ever had that before?
You know what? I actually have. Yeah, I remember having happened. Even though I can't pinpoint a specific moment.
I was like walking next to my parents' bed and there was like a whole bunch of yellow jackets on the ground, on the like carpet. And I could feel it stinging the bottom of my foot. And I looked and I was like, oh, it's a whole bunch of yellow jackets that are stinging me. I've also had scary lucid dreams too. There was a priest in the bar and I told the priest, what do you think about dreams being like pathways to higher dimensions of space and time? And then all of a sudden everyone just stopped and looked at me like Inception.
Yeah.
I was like, okay, I broke some type of dream rule. So I'm like, I'm getting the hell out of here. And I ran. But what do you think? Why do you think we have nightmares?